Welcome back to another VTScada training video. This is the final video in the Parameterized Page series. This series started with instructions to create a simple parameterized page. That video ended with the question of how to deal with complex parameterized pages, those with many widgets and therefore needing many parameters. Our goal is to create a complex parameterized page that needs only one parameter instead of 10 or 50. Let's start in the Idea Studio with the tag widget from the last video. I know that it's a tag widget because of the icon. And if I open the widget properties ribbon, I can check the list of tag types to which this widget can be linked. That shows the pump type tag created in an earlier video. If this was a plain widget or a simple group instead of being a tag widget, then the tool to open the list of tag types would be disabled. Only tag widgets can be linked to tags. Let's review that tag type. Opening the tag browser, I can see pump1 and pump2. Opening the properties of pump1, I see that it's an instance of the pump type, also that it has two parameters. Digging in a bit further, let's look at one of the child tags. Flow is a good example. The description is blue, telling me that this is configured with an expression. I can see that by hovering over it. In the I/O tab, there's also an expression for the address field, which uses one of the parent parameters. And in the scaling tab, we see where the other parameter is used. Moving back to the Idea Studio, I have a pop-up page for a pump detail. Again, it's the icon that tells me that this is a pop-up page. I'm going to clean this page so that it contains only one instance of the pump control widget. Next, I add a parameter. In the Page Properties ribbon, click Manage. In the Manage dialog, click Add. The parameter will hold a reference to the pump type tag, so name it accordingly. Give it a friendly description. Set the type to Tag. And select the type from the list. Click OK to finish, and again to close the Manage dialog. It's helpful to set a value for that parameter, so click the Value tool, select either pump, and click OK to close the dialog. Right-click on the widget and open its properties. Change the data source from tag to parameter. Select the parameter that you just created. Select the Disable Trend and Disable Navigation options, and click OK. Now I need a way to open the page and tell it which pump to display. I move to the Overview page in the Idea Studio and open the Page Navigation palette. Drag a page button to the screen, open its properties, change the label to refer to Pump 1, select the Pump Detail page, and select Pump 1 as the parameter value. Repeat for Pump 2. And switch to the operator view to test that. It would be nice if the page told us which pump we're looking at, so let's add one more feature. Back in the Idea Studio for the page properties. Open the Title tool and choose to add an expression. We know that the parameter is going to hold a pump type tag, and we know that that has a name property, so all the expression need do is display that. Let's see how that worked. Not bad. This does take a bit of work to create, but it can cut hours of tedious repetition from a large project. And as always, there's more detail to be found in the documentation.